Welcome to Medex Physiotherapy. Today I am going to explain on types of pain and how we can find out or rule out a particular area or particular structure involved in related to the pain. The first most important thing, because sometimes there is some false perception, the person we go to some unrelated medical help so that it is a confusion takes place in every individual. For example, if a person get left shoulder pain, automatically he thinks some cardiac problem or something. We have to know that either what type of pain it is, how it is the character or nature of the pain. So that once we know the nature of the pain, so that we can find out a particular physician or a related doctors to find out, and we have to go for a particular treatment instead of confusing different things. I am going to explain today types of pain. The one thing we have to know that in the types of pain, there are the first most important, this we can know that muscular pain, bony pain, and neural pain, and vascular pain. I'm going to explain each and individual how, what are the characteristics of a muscular pain and the characteristics of the bony pain and characteristics of the inflammatory pain and characteristics of the neural pain and characteristics of vascular pain. The first thing I'm going to explain about muscular pain. Muscular pain usually it takes place in whichever muscles is involved. For example, if a person got an injury, a direct hit or trauma to the particular area, we can the person feels it's a dull aching pain. We can its characteristics we can tell as a dull aching pain. It doesn't radiate or it doesn't spread to any other part. It will be remains in the particular region, and it only during a movement the pain will aggravate the particular muscle movement, the particular muscle action. When it takes place, that time only it produces pain, otherwise it will be reduced. And we can also see some spasm, that means tightness of the muscle in the particular region. That is a we can call it as a muscular pain. When it is comes to the bony pain, the bony pain, it is like if a fracture or fall down or any injury directly to the bone, or we can fracture that. The nature of pain will be stabbing, or it may be it's a stabbing nature in pain, like something is piercing inside our body. That nature of pain, it is intolerable pain, that we can call it as a like a bony pain. And that is usually takes place in a fracture or any injury or stress fracture. These types we can find out, we can experience the stabbing pain in the fractures, and it's in a bone especially. And when it comes to the neural, especially in the neural pain, we usually call it as it is a radiating in nature. For example, if a person got any pain in a neck, or it may be in the back, that nerve which supplies to the corresponding area. For example, from the neck it is supplies to the brachial plexus, to the upper limb, as well as in the back or in the chest, like a long thoracic nerve. And these nerve, whenever it get compressed, that nerve, the pain will be radiated to the particular region, from the neck to the shoulder or elbow or wrist. And that nature is called as radiating pain. We can see in the nerves. If a person got any back pain, or it may be involved with the back, that pain will be radiated from back to the hip or knee, then it may be to the ankle or foot. This is the nature of the neural pain. And now when we comes to the vascular pain, again it's a vascular means blood vessel pain, that we can classify it into two types, like one it is arterial and venous. The venous pain, like example, if it is a venous occlusion, if it is a veins get occluded or it may be blocked, that type of pain will be like it is a diffuse pain. Especially we can call it as a we can't find out a exact region, like a exact point out, the patient cannot able to point out. The vascular pain will be diffused, especially it will be diffused, it may be diffused to the entire limb. Like if it is a person got any vascular occlusion, like major veins, the entire limb will get diffuse, and it will be red in color and the swollen, and the patient can't able to point out a particular region, that we can call it as a venous pain, or it may be vascular pain. And when we come to arterial pain, it's usually we can see in Burgers disease and the patients with excessive smoking, and then atherosclerosis formation in the arteries, and then decreased blood supply to the particular area. In that, the it will be bluish discoloration of the limb because of lack of oxygen to the entire area, and it burning is a nature of pain, will be burning. It is a diffuse again, and it's a burning in nature. And when we comes to visceral pain, there's another part of the pain, it's a visceral pain. How to this visceral pain, always it's a referred pain. We can when you come to neural, it is a radiating. When it is comes to visceral, it is referred pain. Referred means it is a like visceral structure, it is a connection with the autonomic nervous system, and these autonomic nervous system also connect embedded with the our peripheral nervous system. So that if it is a viscera get affected, it is radiating the sensory information to the corresponding sensory nerves. For example, if a person got any cardiac arrest or cardiac problem, is a vascular, if it is in a heart problem, then what will happen? The person pain, there's a the myocardial infraction, that type of pain will refer to the shoulder because it is corresponding to the brachial plexus, so that the sensory nerves also embed with the this autonomic nervous system. So that the pain usually viscera is carries from autonomic nervous system, A delta and C fibers, along with this nervous system that carries the pain to the peripheral nervous system. This is also, that's a referred pain. And we can also see one more example I can give. Referred pain is a if appendicitis, if it is any inflammation in the appendix, then it referred to the MacBurney spine, that's in abdominal region, lower abdominal region. That is all we can call it as a referred pain. These are the different varieties of pain. I'm going to explain, for example, if a simple thing, how we can differentiate. For example, if a cardiac and non-cardiac pain in related to the pain. If a person having a truly cardiac pain, it is related to exertional pain. For example, if a person after having a dinner or meals, immediately start to sweat, and the pain will start in the chest region, and it is radiating to the shoulder, that we can call as a cardiac pain. If it is a non-cardiac pain, how we can rule out? For example, if a person get a continuous pain in the shoulder, it is not relevant to the your movements. For example, you can stare 10 steps, automatic, that will not aggravate the pain in your shoulder. It is constant. So that if it is a constant pain, it is not relevant to your exertion, then it is a non-cardiac pain. It is non-cardiac means it may be muscle or any other structure involvement in the shoulder or in neck or in the back. That is a non-neural. If it is a neural and non-neural, how we can differentiate for either cardiac or non-cardiac? Cardiac pain is usually is exertion related. If a person is exerted, means any physical activity, or you know, even after dinner, or even after walk, or even after stair climbing, the pain aggravates, that means we can suspect if a cardiac involvement. If a person the pain is constant, even is rest also is having the same pain, that means is a non-cardiac. It is not subsiding with the rest also, that means is a non-cardiac. It may be neural or it may be muscular. We have to rule out. The first most important, if any person have to come to know that what type of pain he is getting, either it is a visceral or it is muscular or it is bony or neural. That's the main thing to rule out, or we can go for a particular treatment. For example, unnecessarily misguide or misdiagnosed, and you are going to some, for example, one patient, what I am seeing in my clinic, a patient come with a left shoulder pain, and he gone to immediately to one of the big cardiac hospitals. They have done simply a lot of cardiac measures. They are not rule out the characteristics of the pain. They simply done 3 times echo, 3 times ECG, and 3 times TMT, and their patient has normal. Then they simply kept in ICU, and then later on the patient is diagnosed as a cervical radiculopathy. That means a patient also should know that it is a what type of pain and where I have to go and get the good treatment. This is one of the most important and please you have to know and study, or you can go through this pain and different types of pain, so that you can go to a particular physician or surgeon or with the therapist. You have to rule out, you can get a good treatment. If a vascular pain, I already explained, it's a diffuse and it is not, we can't able to pinpoint. Always it is a diffuse pain. And the vascular problem, again I explained, it is a arterial or venous. The venous block, what will happen? It will be reddish color and it will be swollen leg and it will be painful. It will be heaviness in the leg, and also it is having a pain, in a diffuse pain. In arterial pain, it will be decreased the blood supply to the area and the shrink on the shrunken of the skin, and there's a discoloration, and so it will be look bluish discoloration, and this is a burning sort of pain, that is in a arterial insufficiency. Thanking you, please subscribe my channel and please watch everyday updates.